Hello everyone. Learning how to use props or visual aids effectively is a specific art, and appropriately is one of the best gift you can have as a speaker. The word prop comes from theatrical property, and if you watch a play, you may see that various types of props are usually used just to create realm to the story and to help advance the narrative. Common props such as tables, chairs, lamps, and many other things are usually used in a play or even in a presentation. Slide presentations such as PowerPoint, Keynote, Prezi, and are also props. And however, they are such a specialized form of prop in your presentation that they deserve a separate consideration, and we may be talking about them in a separate session as well. The well-timed use of well-chosen props can make a big impression upon the audience. Props can help a presentation in several ways. We may be discussing in today's session that they can make a presentation where you can concentrate or you can gain the concentration of the audience on certain point, and even emotional impact can be created, and you can also effectively use the metaphors and many other things while you are using props in your presentation, and even they can inject humor into your presentation. Once if you have thought of using props, that means definitely you are going to create an impact and effect in your presentation. They focus the audience attention and interest, whether it is maintained or not. That's why it is called, if you want your audience to be helped to know the characterization and many other things that are associated with the presentation, then prop up your presentation. That is the most essential thing that you can do. The word prop comes from the term theatrical property, as I had already talked to you. If you watch a play, props are the objects used by many of the actors just to create an impact. Even the actors use certain sort of dresses, setting, just to enhance characterization, aid the actor in the stage business, and add symbolism to the play. These are all the roles for which we can use prop in our presentation. Props play significant role. They are the object that the speaker uses to enhance the impact of a presentation. It doesn't make much difference whether your prop is small in size or it is huge in size. Most props are small enough to be handled by the presenter, and along with that, we can also use certain big props as per the requirement of our presentation, and even it should be related to your presentation. Unnecessary prop should always be avoided. Slide presentations such as PowerPoint, Keynote, or Prezi are also props. You may see I have also used a prop in my presentation. They are such a specialized form of props. Once if we are willing to talk about them, we need to take a separate session, and we are going to take. Props help a presentation. They can make a point to concentrate. They can create emotional impact in your presentation. Along with that, effective metaphors can be infused in your presentations. Once if you are good at selecting appropriate props in your presentation, they can even inject humor in your presentation if you wish to create. Once if you are thinking of using any prop in your presentation, they usually focus that whether the audience is interested, whether they are taking interest in your presentation, whether their attention is gained or not, whether your presentation is becoming a memorable one or not, that you need to No, once if you are aware of all these things, the well-timed use of well-chosen prop can make a big impression on the audience, and prop always help in various ways once if you have selected them as per the requirement of your presentation. There are some tips that we may see, such as the prop must be relevant to the message that you must have taken for your presentation. Suppose if you are planning a presentation or a program for retirement, then the props are to be included as per the requirement of that particular event. You should always select an objective of your speech in your presentation, and accordingly you can add on certain props to enhance the impact and to create or gain attention of the audience. But you should be sure enough that the audience can see the prop. The prop may not be that much significant, important for you, but it is the most important thing for audience once if you have thought of including prop in your presentation. So if you have larger audience, you should always use the prop in accordance to that, so that the audience may not feel like frustrating whatsoever and howsoever insignificant the prop you may have used in your presentation. It should be visible properly, and they should get a chance of looking or having a look of that prop in a particular way. Use the right number of prop, but who is going to tell you that how many props are the appropriate number for your presentation? There is no right number of props to use, though in many cases one will suffice, and in other cases you may even use props up to 9 to 10 in numbers. The nature of props, whether the props are related or not, that is more important. No two speeches are same, and each requires its own recipe to turn out right. That means there may be more videos, yet you need to, on the same topic, still you need to think over on certain things so that you can make or you can create an impact or difference or a difference in that particular video, in that particular presentation, in that particular topic, so that your topic can be more effective than the other one. Although the events, although the presentations are on the same topic, still you can create a difference once if you have thought of including certain appropriate props in your presentation. But you need to make sure that your prop may work. They should always work properly once if you have thought of including them. Otherwise, you can avoid using them if you have any doubt that your prop may work. Show the prop in your presentation. If by any chance it is an invention, then you need to take care of it. Prior presentation, you should always test it so that you may always avoid these sort of conditions when your prop may not work properly in your presentation, because then it may create an adverse effect to your presentation once if the prop is not working properly. You can see here a live prop. Have a backup in case the prop doesn't work. This you need to take care. If by any chance you have included a complicated prop in your presentation, then you should always check it prior. And in case the prop doesn't work at that particular moment, you should have a backup so that it should not seem that the crop is not working or there is something that is not working, you should never create this sort of environment. Once if you have thought of including a prop in your presentation, should ensure that prop should work. Along with that, you should be comfortable using the prop, whether it is a small, whether it is a big. This means revealing the prop, handling it and operating it, and putting it away, and of course speaking about it comfortably. You must be comfortable in handling the prop from start to finish. Then only the effectivity of using your prop can be enhanced. Keep the prop hidden once if you are not using it, or it is more necessary that at the time when you wish to use that prop in your presentation, you should show it or reveal it in front of the audience. Otherwise, it will distract the audience, or it will distract the attention of the audience. While you are talking about something else, they may not listen to you. They will only think about that particular prop that you must have kept on the stage. If the prop is greater and if it is seen or if it is visible, then you need to take care at the time. At the particular moment only, you should bring the prop on the stage. Talk about the prop prior showing to it. It is a best strategy. Once if you have thought of using a prop in your presentation, you should always disclose certain facts about that prop that you are going to use in your presentation. The prop, once if you have disclosed the specifications of the prop, the impact may be greater when it is revealed. Of course, this requires the right choreography, and the prop needs to live up to the expectation that you must have created. But still, once if you have already told about the prop, a sense of anticipation before the audience you may see. Put the prop away when you are finished with it. You can see such nice, beautiful props, and if they are kept, they will be the center of attraction on the stage. So once if you are finished with the prop, you should remove those props. You can take assistance of someone if you wish to remove the prop from the stage when you are finished with them. Otherwise, the prop could be a distraction for the rest of your talk once if you are not removing that prop from the stage. One more important significant thing, that be creative with your props. Once if you are thinking of using certain props in your presentation, you should never use those type of props that are very common and the audience may feel monotonous once if they are having a look on those props that are not unusual. So you should always use unusual props. They can create the real impact that you may wish to create. And along with that, think about metaphors for the point you are trying to make, and then look for the relevant prop, and accordingly, in accordance with your relevance, you can use the prop, infuse the prop in your presentation, and definitely you are going to enhance the impact. So once if you are done with the prop, you should always eliminate the prop. Along with that, well-timed use of well-chosen prop can make a big impression upon the audience. So you need to take care of all these things that we have discussed today. Props can help a presentation in many ways, and once if we are cautious enough to use these props in a presentation, we can really gain the real impact that we may have wished to create.